sunshine, give me love.
Just really hope that we don't have the same problems we had last week. That was in the video last week and it irritated me the entire time.
What?
That hand sanitizer. I just broke mine.
Yikes! Oh my goodness.
Like, this is what my life has been all week, y'all, because I had to take my nails off for... My hands without nails just piss me off. Like, they just look dumb. But what's going on, YouTube? It's me, Tiffany, and I'm here with my co-host, Tanea.
Hey, guys.
And we're back with an all-new video. Today is...
Oh, you know what? I shut that vent. That's probably why it's cold.
It's been shut the vent, trying to not let the weed go up the stairs or through the vents.
Sorry.
Oh, my God.
Just, I'm like, I got that shit kicking.
It's pumping, bitch. I want to sit over here. Is this one behind this one?
Oh, I don't know if this is a real bed.
You should come through that. Dang. Bitch, we could have been warm.
Sorry. Sorry.
Today is Friday.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Do-do-do-do. Thank you, Lord! Thank you, Lord! Sorry. No, I could have kept going.
I mean,
I literally could have kept going.
Do what you gotta do. December the 8th.
Yep.
Happy birthday, Nicki Minaj.
Happy birthday, Nicki Minaj.
And we're back with an all new video. You know, I know what you guys are thinking. It's not Thursday. Because the thing is that y'all know how a schedule gets towards the end of the year.
Yeah, it's Christmas time.
Look, I have to shop. I don't want to. It's giving me major anxiety. Like, every dollar that I spend, a gray hair appears. Like, I am so tired of spending money on these kids and these people that I just want them to come and go, honestly. Y'all know I'm a Christmas person. I'm loving the Christmas music, the lights, the tree, all that shit. I just want it to come and go so that I can go ahead and be back on track with my money, because my shit is all over the place. But so that's what we did Thursday. We went to do a little Christmas shopping.
Just a little bit.
A little bit. We went to Chick-fil-A. Today was the Friday from hell for me at work. My coworker was off, so I had to do her job, which she is the operator. I used to be the operator, but I'm no longer the operator. I haven't been the operator for some years now, and honestly, I was the operator for about 8 years. So now when I have to answer the phone for an hour, I'm stressed, but today I had to answer it for 8. So I'm worn out. Like, if I didn't have to say nothing to nobody for the rest of the day, I would be fine. Like, I hate answering the phone. I hate talking to people. I hate having to be pleasant. Like, it's just too much for me. I can't take it. Then my job, like, the directory is just not updated. So when you send somebody somewhere, like, they just come right back to you, like,
damn.
Oh, my God.
Damn.
Then when I got off, because now there's supposedly this scare that we're getting 3 to 4 inches of snow. So I was just like, the best thing, the smart thing,
the right thing
would be to go to the market today. Like, don't wait, because we was gonna go tomorrow. There's no need to wait tomorrow. Cause I don't know. Honestly, I don't know what time is starting. Like, the times is all over the place. That I'm just like, the right thing to do.
Oh shit.
Damn, 80%.
Oh shit. Shit!
See?
A bitch might not be able to go get her nails done. And that's gonna be tragic if I can't get my nails done.
It's across the
street. No, it's just depending if our nail tech comes.
Oh, she won't come. She got a truck. But, yeah, so the right thing to do is go to the market, but I was so hungry and so tired. So I made the bad decision of getting curry out tonight. Mm-hmm. I hate eating curry out, and I hate eating it late. If I'm gonna eat curry, y'all, I like to have it for lunch because it just sits on your stomach. So now I'm stuffed. No, I don't want to smoke no weed.
Oh.
I'm stuffed. Like, I'm just so full. I'm miserable. But I wanted y'all to have this video because I don't know how things are gonna be because Christmas is on Monday.
Right.
So we won't. Oh, but I'm going to try which I call it a vlogmas. I'm going to try.
Don't fall for it again, y'all.
New Year's Eve, we're actually going to the Ravens versus Bengals game. So, you know, I'm going to try to do a New Year's vlog too. We'll see. We'll see what happens.
Because, Jesus, it's going to be cold.
It's going to be cold as shit. But yeah, that's all we've been doing since we last saw y'all Monday. We don't even have that many topics, but I just wanted y'all to see us to start y'all weekend off, or if this video even gets up tonight, or if it's even recording, because you never know with this fucking camera. But first of all, I want to send my prayers and love and concerns and just to everybody in California who are dealing with the California fires. Oh my God, like. I told you that Uncle L was like kind of bi-coastal now, so I had to text him like, are you okay out there? Because I heard it's like L.A.
No, it's not in L.A. It's close to L.A.
Yeah, they call it the L.A. fires.
Because it's like the closest, largest, most known county.
Oh, okay.
I actually talked to one of my customers today, and she said it's not down by her.
Oh, great. Yeah, because Uncle Al said he in the city, so he was like, it's not in the city. He was like, he fine.
Yeah.
But I heard that Chrissy Teigen had to evacuate her house.
A lot of
Chelsea
celebrities had to evacuate.
Mm-hmm. It's just dangerous. You know, we don't deal with, I mean, we had fires over here, but not in large amounts like that. And I think it's because they have, like, what, a lot of trees around
here? Yeah.
Yeah, and that's just scary. Like, because when I saw the video of the car driving down the beltway and all you saw is fire in the background, it's like, how do y'all deal with that? Like, what does it smell like over there?
It literally was just a fire over there. So it was just like, how do you deal with that on a daily?
Right, like, it happens for days at a time. Like, it happens for days at a time. So I just don't know. You know, like, it would be like something over here that happens. Like, people that are in California that have never experienced snow. When y'all see a blizzard, y'all probably like, how the fuck do you, how does this work? Like, the snow is up to your door. How does this?
I mean, that's just like when that, Georgia got that snow and they know what the fuck to do was literally.
It's actually snowing in Georgia right now.
Really?
Yeah, a lot. Yes, it snowed in Mississippi today. It snowed in Georgia today. It's crazy. But yeah, so prayers to y'all. That's scary. You know, I just wanted to say, you know, everybody be careful. You know, the holiday season and fires make me so nervous because if you have a real tree in your house and if let's say the tree didn't even start the fire, because a lot of those real trees, if you don't water them correctly, you know, it'll catch on fire. But let's say it wasn't that. Like, let's say you had a candle on fire and it got to the curtains, and then from the curtains it got to the tree. Once that tree gets fire on it, it's over. Like, it literally burns your house to the ground, like,
quick.
I was watching a video of them, like, just showing a demonstration on the news the other day of when fire hits it. I mean, it literally went up, like, just boom. Everything was just on fire. Like, it's just so dangerous. So, yeah, I grew up with real trees. I never had to really take care of them. I just remember, like, the little pieces being on the floor getting stuck in my fucking foot.
Annoying.
Having a vacuum, the smell.
Sneezing my face off.
Yeah, I'm happy with my fake tree, but not just the people with real trees, just everybody, you know, with the lights and the candles, and just be careful, please. Like, it gives me anxiety just thinking about it, like, because it's just so easy for shit to get real,
true.
Right? So just please be careful with everything, all of the extension cords you're using for your lights and stuff. You know, I know some of y'all, like the man across the street from us, he wants to be Griswold.
Yo, it looks like Griswold, and he's not even done.
So it's like, please, like, for people like that, please, please be careful.
Please be careful.
What else we got? Yo, did you hear Mama Tina joke today? My corny joke?
I never listened to one.
Oh my God, it's my favorite thing. I have to fix my phone, bitch.
You're not gonna say this.
Please, somebody remind me. Say, Tiffany, unsync y'all phones. Mama Tina corny joke today. I love her corny jokes. Her corny joke today was, do you know why Santa Claus's sack is always so heavy?
Oh my God.
Because he only comes once a year. The first thing that I did was at Beyonce and Solange, and I said, y'all, please, like, this is it. This is the joke that y'all have to come and get her ass.
Shut that shit down.
Now, call Instagram and get Tina's page shut down.
Shut her down.
Because she's out of control. Oh, okay. And I love Tina's jokes, but this was it. Like, I was like,
where did she get this from?
Yo, Tina's out of control.
What are you talking about, man?
Me problem with Tina, because I was like, Tina. I didn't do anything but go straight to Beyonce and Solange, and I added them on Twitter. I know Beyonce don't even be on Twitter. Come get your mother.
Yeah, come.
Come collect her ass. Net, where's Richard? Somebody come get her.
He sent back, let her do whatever the hell she
wanted to do. When she be taking videos and she turned to him, he just be like, hey y'all, like. Girl, but we watched the motorsport video just now, actually. But I heard people talking about it. I didn't hear anything about the whole video. I just kept hearing about Nicki Minaj versus Cardi B.
That's all people.
My first question is, why does it have to be a competition?
Right. Like, why can't it just be two ladies?
Why can't it be a competition? I mean, why does it have to be a competition? Like, why do y'all want Nicki and Cardi to hate each other?
So much. Like, y'all want to put them at odds so bad. Let these two young women flourish.
It's strange, but if I had to pick my favorite part, it would be Nicki Minaj. I mean, Nicki Minaj looks fucking amazing.
She looks
her so body amazing. And her hair. And you know, big butts and all, every now and then they cute. I really don't like these antlers on the back and shit. Like, it's a lot for me, like Kim K and them. So sometimes Nicki's ass can be a bit much. But I feel like she looked good in this video.
She looked real good this day.
I love the braids. I love the braids. It's like pink lemonade, bitch. People have been comparing, putting her and Beyonce, when Beyonce had braids and the Formation video together for days now.
I want them to come out with another song. I need another song, another video, both for braids.
I don't know if Beyonce's ready for that.
Yes, please.
I don't know if Beyonce's ready to hit, because it's like Nicki Minaj.
Give us what the people want.
Nicki Minaj is good. Don't get me wrong. But it's like Beyonce literally has to pull her by her hand and make her do the right thing.
She made her better now, though.
Did y'all see Beyonce when they were rehearsing for the show?
That was before she elevated.
And Beyonce was like pushing her ass and get it. Let's go.
That was before. Now she's better. And Beyonce introduced her to real, and now she hate lame.
Nicki Minaj is better?
Yes, she's doing better. Dang.
She's doing better enough for Beyonce?
She was doing better enough for Beyonce to take her the first time.
Because Beyonce pushed her ass.
And you don't think she learned after that?
Y'all know I love Nicki, so it's no shade. Plus, it's your birthday.
You already fight you.
But I saw a couple people that braid hair, and they was like, let me tell y'all something right now. What you won't do is come to my shop thinking that these braids are going to be $150, because it's just not happening. These motherfuckers is $300 off the back. Like,
damn!
First of all, that's a lot of hair.
That's a lot. You know who did her hair?
Who?
Kim Campbell.
Oh, so it's a wig?
Oh, I don't know if it's a wig. Let me know why, babe. I think that's what she said.
Don't Kim Campbell do wigs?
She also do regular hair. You remember she taught fucking...
I mean, of course she braids the wig, but I didn't know she like literally was braiding into people's wigs.
Yeah, she probably is a hairstylist. She does everything.
But Nicki looks great. I love the rest of the video. You know, Cardi was good. Offset, the Migos was lit. I like how they bringing the goggles back. Made me want to pull mine back out.
No, please.
That was lit. The goggles...
They are on them.
For the people who aren't old enough... When the goggles were out, you wore them cocked to the side. Those were the times. Take me back. What's that, the making of it?
Look at this
one. I know, I saw that shit. Nicki looks so good.
She do look so
good. I love that she's wearing her hair to her ankles these days. It's just such a nice time for me.
Who about to get a weave?
Who?
Yep, Pink Inches by Kim Campbell.
Makeup by Sheika. This fucking cat. What else do we have?
Did I hit the 13, please?
No, you didn't. Let's talk about Drea. Let me pull up what she said. Because, see, my thing about Drea is, because y'all know I follow Drea on shit. I follow Drea. No, I actually took her off of my Twitter because she was getting a little crazy one day, so I just had to get rid of her. But I follow her on Snap, and I follow her on IG. I think I still do. I know I follow her on Snap. Okay, so I don't understand you, Drea. It's like you really bring these Twitter things upon yourself. Like, it's like there's no reason for you to post some of the stuff that you post. Where is it?
That's on my IG.
Where?
On either the shade or my baller.
You saw the thing?
Yeah.
Oh, here it is. Okay. So this is what Drea put on Instagram. Let's discuss this. Nico, who, if you don't know who Nico is her son. Nico has this 4-minute speech he has to memorize and recite. Fine. Splendid. Now his teacher is requiring me to sign papers every day saying he's read the speech 5 times out loud and stuff. Over Thanksgiving break, I had to sign 18 times and now it's still every day. Here's my point. I'm all for helping my child with his homework, but at this point, she has him harassing me with the speech. I don't want to hear it no more. I'm hearing it 2 times a day for a month straight. I'm finna memorize it. Not to mention the topic is about American history isn't present as much in college education with all the sleeping faces. So you can imagine what a snooze this thing is. Last night he asked me to sign and I said no. Tell your teacher I'm done with this. And now today he doesn't get points because I don't want to sign it. It's not my damn homework, but it feels like it. What y'all think?
You a dumbass bitch.
And like, now,
why would you even put that shit out?
Okay. Here's the thing. Now, I'm not going to lie to you.
That would be annoying.
Annoying if I had to sign some shit like that for Kari every day. I would be like, come on now, what the fuck?
I would be drawing a line. Or I would be kicking Kari how to sign my name.
Like, what the fuck are you talking? Like, how many? Like, at this point, I would have memorized it. But I would definitely, if it was going to make him lose points, it's no question about it. I would definitely be signing it. And I feel like a child has one job. And that's to be educated. That's to go get their education.
Cindy.
It's the truth. It's to get their education. So if all you had to do for the day or your biggest responsibility right now is to
sign in his paper.
No, I mean if your biggest responsibility right now is to memorize this speech, then let's hear it 2 times. Let's get it. And then I'm going to sign it real quick. Yes, it's going to be annoying, but I'm going to sign it. Even if I feel like it's annoying, me, Drea, the person who was accused of neglecting my child, when anybody thinks about Drea, that's the first thing they think of.
I wouldn't even mention myself if I was Drea.
Y'all would have never saw Nico again. Like, she be putting Nico on Snapchat so much. I guess the point, like, when she go buying tennis, they be going
We know you got him now.
Listen, Drea, you set yourself up because they've been dragging Drea since last night.
Yeah, I kept on seeing Drea shit, but I was like, I don't know what's going on because I don't follow Drea on anything.
Somebody said Drea is such a bum ass parent.
Damn.
Some of y'all are worse mothers than Drea. Who the hell is Drea?
Right.
I'm still cracking up at Drea. The internet really be killing Drea.
The internet really do be killing Drea, but that bitch be resurrecting.
We recording, don't come down here. She always, it's like everybody in this house waits until we recording.
The cat.
But it's like, they're dragging her, and I almost want to feel bad, but Drea, I can't because, again, whenever, especially if you watch the Basketball Wives back then, when you think of Drea, especially people who haven't kept up with her, they don't know that she is the fiance of, you know, of a football player, and she has this new baby, and she has all these different businesses.
Does she have twins?
He has twins.
Oh.
He had twins before they were together. So when she met them, they was like 2.
Oh,
Oh, she has Nico and she has Drew.
Oh, I just can't remember what she
had. All together, they had 4 kids. But it's like, she doesn't know, you know, people who haven't kept with her doesn't know that she's a great stepmother. Because I can say that just from social media. I can see that. They don't know, you know, that Drea is not this person that she was on season 1 of Basketball Wives. Sure. So it's like, Drea, why would you do this knowing what the fuck is... That's just like her putting her Thanksgiving, the showing how she did every part of her Thanksgiving meal. And then coming on fucking Instagram and zapping the fuck out of everybody like, y'all don't know, I've been cooking for myself for a very long time. Bitch, why would you do this?
Right.
You knew that you were going to be attacked.
Yeah.
They can't wait to attack you, Drea. Yeah. Drea, you should have sent it in a group. Yo, I put up this thing a couple weeks ago and it literally said, like, you won't see half of my problems on social media because I have a group chat full of friends.
Right.
Mine ain't even that damn full. 2 of the most important friends that I have are in this group chat, and if I have a fucking problem or I need to vent, boom!
Yo, it's always open.
It's always open!
Anything.
Yo, Simone messages me at 2 o'clock in the morning like it's 2 o'clock in the afternoon.
She don't give a fuck about nothing.
It's nothing. Like,
we have brain sessions. We have emoji wars. Like, anything. Like,
it's just strange. Like, Drea, I want to feel bad for you, but because what I'm saying is another parent may feel that way. Like, it may be annoying to them. And another parent may even say, you know, like, I'm not signing shit up. This teacher's fucking crazy. You want to put it on Instagram?
Right.
Okay. You want it to be slaughtered. Yeah. And it, that was yesterday at this time. They're still going
that
in.
That shit is funny, though.
They're still going
Yo,
in.
Yo, you want to know my favorite one? It's the one when it be like when Dre about to go on, when Dre see her son and she about to go on vacation, and it is fucking Tariq on the elevator going like this. That shit is so.
It was another one with Ghost. The
Yes, that was so funny too. They all so good. See, that's the one thing about Black Twitter. Y'all is some clever ass niggas. Yo, I love y'all.
They done put Drea face on top of Precious mother face when she's sitting there holding.
No. No. What's wrong with y'all? Y'all, some of y'all really, really need to go to school for computer smart shit.
Okay. So, tell them about Beyonce popping up the other day.
Because we didn't even know where the fuck she was going. We just saw a picture of her.
No, because see, the thing is, the day before pictures of, that was the day before, this was the day after Jay-Z's birthday. And the next day, he was performing in Chicago, and I knew Ashley Miller was going. So I was thinking Beyonce was going to be in Chicago. You know, I thought Ashley was going to see it because I knew Ashley was going to have some good seats.
Right.
And that's what all was loving to me. But Beyonce has had other plans.
And so we had no idea. And Beyonce popped her ass up to give Colin Kaepernick to give Colin Kaepernick the Sports Illustrated Muhammad Ali Legacy Award.
Yeah. And you know, it was just great to see Beyonce. From what I'm hearing,
who knew that she was coming?
From what I'm hearing, Collins, WCW. He has a crush on her. So
Beyonce.
Mm-hmm.
Oh.
I personally don't think that's the reason that they asked Beyonce to do this because I just can't see Jay-Z saying like, yeah, let him bother my life.
Right. Like I don't mind her being his WCW.
No, but it's really good to see her supporting and so many others up high supporting Colin because he needs that. You know, he lost his whole fucking job just to prove a fucking point.
Right.
And I love it. And Beyonce, let's see, the other day we kept getting these little snippets. We got a little video.
Right.
Today, Beyonce dropped her own pictures. Those ones that she take backstage and in the garage and on the elevator. Bitch. Let me just say this. I was just telling Tanae, Beyonce looks way better than she did when she was younger. Like,
yeah.
I don't know how. Yo, Beyonce looks so fucking good. Like, her body is perfect right now. I mean, I know she probably got something holding that gut.
Oh, she got those bangs.
But it's like, I like that because it's like, she's real, just like us. Like, sometimes you gotta suck in the fat. She looks beautiful.
Face beat back, bitch.
Beyonce looks so good, y'all. I'm so mad she. I'm mad you didn't give us no flippogram yet, B. Because you still ain't give us no Halloween, and that was fucked up.
Right,
I
mean, like,
you
damn.
Didn't give us a little
Christmas
Kim.
About to come up now. Like,
but
we
still,
just...
we didn't get the twins or nothing. Like,
I remember when you came out with your Christmas picture last year with your pregnant ass.
Yeah, like Beyonce, I want more. I want more. You should have gave us a flippogram. Yeah.
This inspired me.
Yeah.
Be inspired.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I'm gonna fuck that up.
I told Kari this week when she started dance class this week. I said, you know, you already know my motto. You need to be Beyonce in everything you do. You need to go in here and get your Beyonce on. I don't care if it's your first day. Catch up with the rest of these people. Thanks. You got this. And she had to do what she had to do. Now I told her, you gotta work on your face. You gotta get a little more fierce. But yeah, Beyonce out here looking like a snack as usual. Beyonce was also in Target this week. With Tina and Blue Blue. You know, just trying to be a regular human being like she is. Now, I don't know what Beyonce said, but the hand gesture is letting me know that she said, please, you know, not today.
What if she was saying hi?
No, she wasn't. You could
what? See,
no, come on. You could see the shit all on her fucking face. Like, Stevie Wonder could tell Beyonce didn't want to have her fucking picture taken.
That's her regular face.
Okay. Oh, yeah. Did you see them on the pictures that they had on the elevator on his birthday?
Yes.
Did you see the video?
No.
Oh, my God. Tanaya, I have to show you the video. Beyonce was so pissed at Jay-Z because they were about to get off the elevator. So Jay-Z does like this and gets Beyonce to come back. And he's like, no, no, no. He told Julie. He's like, tell him, come on. The cop takes some pictures. The paparazzi let him take a couple. Beyonce gave Jay-Z the dirtiest look. That's why I know she's what she said. Because the same look she gave Jay-Z when they were in the fucking...
No, who posted it? B-Legion?
I think B-Legion posted
it. Yeah,
that shit is so... Yo, I'm about to find it real quick. That shit is so funny. But what I was about to say was, you know, because I said it to Tanaya, you know, she went in that fucking crazy Beehive mood, you know, it's Beyonce. If I see Beyonce, I'm taking a fucking picture too. But what I'm saying is, if I see Beyonce and I go to lift my camera and Beyonce lifts her hand up and she says, please, not right now.
I'm be like, okay.
You still gonna take it?
I'm only gonna take one.
She's garbage. You're garbage. But this other girl, no. Like, she has
so many pictures. I look out to too many. She went
like, she was following Beyonce around the
right. I wouldn't have did that. I wouldn't have did
that.
That
shit wasn't right.
I would have shot my pick.
I wouldn't have did that. I definitely... Oh, wait, no. Yeah. So, the thing's about to get off.
Wait,
look at Beyonce again. Did you see it?
She was cussing his ass.
Yeah! But like, why would he do that? She was ready to fucking go.
She was cussing his ass out.
You could tell, like, I've been a fan of Beyonce for a while. Like, I feel like I can just tell when she's
but that pissed me off. Why would she start smiling?
Because she's an actress.
Irky ass.
Did you see her after the elevator event?
Yeah, I seen it.
Academy Award winner goes to Beyonce after not Solange. You lost.
Yes, you lost.
We didn't know that you was fighting the elevator, but we damn sure knew you wasn't happy.
Yo, when those videos came out of fucking Solange, yo, I kept on pressing it because I was like, where is the audio?
I still want it. Y'all know it. I think I want the audio to the elevator more than I want the Formation World Tour.
No, that's a definite. That is a definite.
I do. Like,
if Beyonce even said, I'll give you this audio and you'll never get the Formation DVD, I would take that audio.
I think I'll take the audio.
I need to hear it.
I need to know.
I made up in my mind what was going on. I gave everybody a script. Like, I know. But like, now I just gotta hear it. Bring it to life. Please, I would do anything for you.
I told you I would give up an ear. I want it.
I told you that I would give up.
I'm not. But also, Beyonce's choreographer, I think his name is Jaquel Knight, he said that what Beyonce is planning to do at Coachella next year.
Yeah, buddy.
is next level. It's something that we've never seen before. Basically, let me translate it for you. Hold on tight to your wig.
Oh, I'm about to get braids.
Your edges. Because you're going to be bald. She's about to snatch you bitches.
Get my fucking life, B. Yes.
She's about to scalp you bitches. And you know what? They got an emoji coming out, a bald headed one. And it's basically for like cancer patients.
Oh, yes.
But somebody said, this is about to turn Stan. Take Stan-ness on the
internet. Niggas is about to take this. Y'all sure y'all want to do this?
Yo, it's literally for cancer patients.
Are y'all sure? Are y'all sure y'all want to do this? Don't give that to these niggas, please. Please.
Because that's going to be mine the day of Coachella. It's just going to be a single bald-headed girl. Snatch.
You want help? Oh my god.
I think they said, Candy has a new job on Broadway. She's going to be, I think, in Chicago.
No, we didn't. Yes, we did. Because I asked when you brought it up before, I said, if she said
Candy going to be on Broadway.
Because at first I thought she was directing or producing or writing. I thought she was going to write the musical. I mean, the music, the score, whatever it's called.
Yeah, I think that's it. We didn't have a lot of topics, but we do have a What Would Y'all Do?
We did!
Yes, we did.
Oh my god! Can I tell y'all, I never know who the What Would Y'all Do's are from.
Sometimes they're anonymous. Sometimes it's just their email, but I don't know who they are.
Oh, yeah, I don't know.
They never say their name, though.
Oh, right. Okay.
Hi, Tiffany. Hi, Tanea.
Hey!
I need some advice on what y'all would do. This is crazy because Tanea is crazy. Like, it's crazy I think that. Okay. I hate my mother's boyfriend so much.
Whoa.
I'm 16, which means I still have, in caps, to live at home.
I'm not the
crap. I just wish he would disappear. How would y'all deal with this? I mean, he's even coming between me and my mom. The worst part is he's paying a lot of the bills, so it's like my mom just lets him run the place. Please help.
Pray. And I know that that's a lot.
That's what we always say.
I know. First of all, I know that's what we always say. And I know that's probably a lot and probably too mature of an answer for a 16-year-old. But all I can tell you is to pray and that things will get better later. Not probably no time soon, but later. Because it's honestly a fight that you're just not going to win. Ever. You're not going to win it. So it's just like, thank God, like, some people have, like, a best friend to move with or grandparents to move with. But some people don't have that type of escape.
Mm-hmm.
So get some extracurriculars after school. See if you can even get a weekend job to try to keep yourself busy, and you know, you'll be so tired from working that you won't even have time to argue, and just, you know, your room is about to become your paradise.
Get you a job.
So
stay out.
Yeah, like, you know, get you a job, save up, and if you live in a state that needs that, you know, you gotta go to driving school, save up to go to driving school. Like, just do good things, do nice things for yourself, to make yourself, you know, feel good. You know, don't ever, you know, hinder yourself. Just try to be the best you can be, but still pray a lot.
It's a rocky road. This is what I'll say, because, you know, as most of you guys know, I grew up with my stepfather, who I call my father, which was hard in the beginning because I was in a house where everybody had the same last name, everybody called him daddy, you know, my father was off doing his own thing. I never felt like he was, you know, taking my mother away from me. It was from day one. I mean, it was an adjustment, but it was never like he ever mistreated me. It was disrespectful, ever, ever, ever. Now, in my older years, when my mother did get a boyfriend, because I was so used to my stepfather passed away. And some years and years and years later, don't want y'all to think my mother just jumped from
her. Yeah, it was like years.
She was a widow and just got a boyfriend. No, it was like years later. She got into a relationship, and at this point I was older. I wasn't living home anymore. Oh, in the beginning I was, but he wasn't living there. By the time they lived together, I wasn't living there, but my little sister still was. And it was like, you know, me and him really didn't get along. In the beginning we did. You know, he was a really fun person. But you know, it's just like any person. After you be with him for a while, you start to see the good and the bad, right. The parts that you like and the parts that you don't like. And it was a lot that I didn't like, and I just didn't, you know, like, he was just really vocal, and you know, just, it was a lot about him. It was a lot that I could ignore, but my little sister was still living at home. And it was like, I just didn't like the way he talked to her. Sometimes I didn't like the way he treated her. And I mean, even him himself had saw himself one day, you know, like had a reflection, like, you know, I was yelling at her, like he felt bad. And it was like, then one time, this one big thing blew up. And it was at some point, like, I kind of felt like I was going to my mother about it a lot. And, you know, wasn't much happening. And one time something just escalated, and it, you know, it caused me and my mother to stop speaking for a few months, which is something that has never, ever, ever, ever happened in my life. And it also, this was the one time in my life that I had ever disrespected my mother. And to this day, it haunts me at least twice a week, because I have the best mother in the world. You know what I mean? Like, I literally feel like I have the best mother in the world. I feel like she's the sweetest person ever. She's always been there for me. Like, she's my number one. Like, I don't know what I would do without my mother. And it's like, I can't take it back. But that's how far I let him push me.
Right.
Because I was, like, that's how upset that he had gotten me at this point. Like, just a buildup over the years. It was like, this had just took me over the top. And I just feel like what Tanea said is right. You need to come to the realization, especially since you're 16. I think I was probably 18.
I was 16.
I was out of house.
I was literally 16 years old when my mother remarried.
Yeah, it's a hard thing, and it's especially hard because it's like you can't understand why your mother is not sticking up for you. And my right. mother would tell me, she'd be like, you don't know what I'm saying when it's just me and him. But I'm just like, no, like, check his ass in front of me. Like, I want right. to see that shit.
That was my big thing. It's like, my thing was, I don't care about what you're saying to him behind closed doors.
Right.
I want to hear what you're saying to him now.
Right.
That we all in the same room.
Exactly. Like, that's how I felt. And it'll just, at some, like, how you're already feeling, like, you'll just feel like your mother doesn't have your back. Which was something I've never felt in my life before, because my mother is like, that's what everybody knows her for. Like, she always has her kids back.
Oh,
like,
yes.
Even if you weren't doing nothing, if she's already assumed it, you're in trouble.
If she thought.
You're in trouble.
Yeah.
So it was like the first time in my life I felt like she didn't have our back. And that may not necessarily be true, because I don't know what they were saying behind closed doors, but I just felt like in person, like, have my back now. Like,
I'm gonna have my back in life.
Let's bank him. Let's bank him.
That's where I'm at. At this point.
Let's bank him. Like, I just felt like off the bat, like, it shouldn't have been nothing to discuss. You're on my side. He's wrong.
Right. Because it's basically like, you are my mother.
Right.
If you belong to me. And I tell Nene all the time, if you don't belong to nobody, you belong to me.
Right.
Like, what do you mean? So yeah, like, when I tell you, I can 100% feel you.
Like, that's making me sad.
Yeah, and like, it's bringing up like a lot of old feelings and memories, because it's a sad thing, and it's almost like, by you being a child, it's kind of like you stuck.
Right, it's nothing
because
you can
do. Really nothing to do, and it doesn't matter how many talks you have with your mother, how many talks you have with whomever, it's just not, this is not a fight you're gonna win.
And that's why, and my point was, on my hand, was to just don't go as far as I did.
Yeah.
As far as, there's, like, me and my mother's relationship is not ruined or messed up in any way, but I just, me personally, it's just something that's
going to be on me. I don't even think she can remember.
She
does, because she remembers everything.
My mother?
Yeah, no, never mind, because she remembers.
My mother?
Can I tell you something? She may watch the show, so let me not.
My mother?
She'll pull me up quick. So what you say about me? So she remembers everything. But what I'm saying is, I don't think it bothers her.
I don't know
how it bothers her.
And the thought of me, you know, I often say that I want, because I see my mother every day, I talk to my mother every day, but I'm just so, not embarrassed, I'm just so, like, ashamed that I let it go that far, because I do not believe in people disrespecting their mother. Like, and I just feel like for the rest of my life, I'll be sorry for the rest of my life. I just wish that I could just make the money that I want to so that I can just take care of her. Like, like she deserves to be taken care of. Like, she knows.
You have an amazing
mother. I have an amazing mother, and I do love her. It was just such a rough time with this boyfriend, and what I'm saying is I don't want you to let it get this far.
Yeah, don't let it.
Don't let it get this
make
far.
Make you come out of character.
Bite your tongue. Bite that, because that was completely out of my character. You know, bite your tongue. Don't say nothing. Go in your room. You're 16. If you're allowed to, get you a little job. Don't be afraid to work at McDonald's and KFC.
Chick-fil-A.
Yes. Walmart. All of those. Get you a little job.
Do some
your schoolwork.
Yeah,
do some babysitting.
Some babysitting.
Hang with your friends. Do something. You know, just try not to let this take over.
Start reading more.
Yeah.
Like,
get lost in books.
Yeah.
Back then, me and today used to be
something?
In love
with I used to get lost in books all the time.
Yes. All the time.
For days.
And then, like, me and Tanae, like, I can say, especially, like, I feel like when Tanae was going through hers, we were definitely younger. But I was working, but from the minute I got off of work, like, we literally stayed on the phone all night just so she could, you know, have somebody near her. I mean, even though I wasn't near her, we were on the phone. Or if it wasn't me, it was her other best friend. You know, just so she wouldn't have to focus on that was
right.
going on over there. You know what I mean? It's for me, like, the minute that I was old enough to... That's what you gotta do. So you need to go to college, or you need to be saving to get you your best friend, get your place. But you know what I said about moving in with
friends. Yeah, so that may not.
You know what I'm saying. But all I
know that there's better times ahead.
Good luck to you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord, that I'm not in that situation no more. Thank you, God, I didn't go through that at a young age, because I don't know how I would have acted back then. At 16,
and also at 16, you just like your mouth. Is just coming into its best form. Mm-hmm. Like, you just got the best things to say to get smart. You, at that point, are living recklessly. You don't care about life, and you ready to fight anything. Oh, so it's just like, it's an important time.
With me, it was, I had a little sister, and I just have always felt like I needed to protect her. And the minute that I felt like my mother wasn't doing enough, I felt like I needed to step in, because she came to me. She came to me with issues. So it was like, what am I supposed to do? My mother's not doing anything. So I just kind of like lost it. And I do wish that I could have did it a different way, or if I could change that whole day around. But at the same time, sometimes those things happen. So I don't want that to happen to you, though, because every mother's not like my mother.
Right.
That could have really tarnished our relationship if my mother wasn't a woman of God. And if my mother wasn't a forgiving mother.
Right.
And, you know, if I just didn't have that kind of mother. So, I don't know what kind of mother you had. You know what I mean? The crazy thing is, we never know what's going on behind that door.
Right.
You can, in your mind, I can still see the door shut. Can't you see the door shut?
Yeah.
It's like the Freddy Krueger door. Like, I can still see that door shut. So, it's just so crazy. But, I hope we helped you. Keep all this in mind. Anybody else who's going through the same thing, keep that in mind. If anybody has gone through that and you want to comment and give some suggestions,
yes.
Person who sent me this, make sure you read the comments. I hope that I didn't miss on talking about anything, because there really wasn't a lot going on. I don't give a fuck about Roland Martin losing his job.
Who?
Roland Martin.
Who is it?
She don't even know who he is. Dallas said he looked like the California Raisins. Don't forget that.
Yo, did you hear about the politician Roy Moore? What he said?
No.
This nigga, first of all, this is a
that's
nigga.
That's giving me so much satisfaction.
This is a nigga from Alabama who has sexual assault allegations but won't drop out of the race. He said that America was great when slavery was legal, because families cared about each other, and America had a direction.
That's probably how I feel.
Yo.
That doesn't surprise me.
That shit was crazy that he actually said it, though, in an interview.
Yeah, some of them can't hold back, especially when they're upset. Can you do the upside?
It's my upside, not hold up.
It's enough.
First of all, you need to mind your business. This don't have anything to do with you.
Oh my God.
Hey! Camera!
So, I hope you guys have a great weekend. If it's something that we didn't get to talk about and you would like us to comment under this, and we'll talk about it on Monday. I think Monday will be out. Monday and Thursday will be our last two videos, because then it will be, you know, Christmas Eve. And right. I can't believe it. Like, Christmas is like next week.
Yep.
It's crazy. Like, I can't deal.
It's crazy that Christmas is next year and we, next week. And we, last year, we said what we was not going to do. And we back to what we was at last year.
That's the story
of every year.
Story of my life.
When are we going to get it right? Like, I really want to be better.
God, help me.
Help us.
But yeah, I hope you guys have a great weekend. If you're dealing with the snow, be safe. Make sure y'all, you know, chill. Ravens and Steelers play this weekend. Keep us in your prayers, because I'm not trying to get embarrassed again. And, yeah, shout out to Kim. Cowboys are doing terrible.
Yikes.
I heard they have to win Sunday's game when they're out, so.
Is Ezekiel Elliott playing?
I don't think so.
Oh,
if this is your first time watching, make sure you subscribe. We'll be here every Monday and Thursday, I think, with an all new video. For the people who have been watching, make sure you share this video. Tell a friend to tell a friend. Tell your mother, your cousin, your sister, your brother. Tell somebody about the show. And I'll see you guys on Monday, God willing, for an all new video.
Yes, God willing. And if you didn't know, now you know there's no show like the show. We gotta go. It's getting late.
It's getting late. I wanna go to bed.
All that goodness.
Why you gotta be? Look at that.
You really, really need to
look at that.
Broaden your vocal cords. Stretch them out.
Why you gotta be here?
But you also need to control.
Beside me.
You're too nasally.
Beside me. And you want to put out a she's talking about something. It's amazing what they can do in the studio. Bitch, you just told me I can't sing.
Again, it's amazing what they can do in
the
studio.
Saucy, shut up.